Let's go inside the SWAC, brought to you by AARP, Real Possibility.
Talk about an emotional roller coaster of a game with Texas Southern paying a visit to the Southern Jaguars in a terrific SWAC matchup featured on ESPNU. We won't waste any time getting right to the highlights. Southern came out more than ready for this one, especially sophomore guard Traylon Banks, as cool as the other side of the pillow. Had to do that one for the legend Stuart Scott. Banks had 10 of the Jaguars' first 14 points. Father Roman Banks, head coach, approves. And up by 12 after 7 minutes, it was looking like a Jaguar party, but not so fast. Deverell Biggs put the Tigers on his back, though. He had 12 in the first half alone, and a big reason why we went in the halftime tied up at 26. But here's where the real fun starts. Tied at 55, Christopher Hyder. They call him Sebo, and yo, he gets that one to fall. How did he do it? Jaguars go up by 2. Now tied at 58 after a couple of free throws, Tigers going for the win, but it's Sebo again, and he's wide open for the game winner. Shots blocked, and to make matters worse for the Jaguars, the refs call a foul on freshman Jared Sam. That means it's on Chris Thomas to sink the free throws, no pressure. With less than a second left on the clock, he makes the first, misses the second, last chance for the Jaguars with 0.5 seconds. Adrian Rogers and Southern think they've won it, but the refs say he didn't get the shot off in time. Tigers win 59-58.
You know, I haven't really reviewed all that yet, but, you know, we executed all the way to the end.
So at the end of the day, we have to live with the call the referees make on the floor, but it doesn't mean you have to like them. And we can only hope that the next matchup between Texas Southern and Southern is just as much fun. For now, in the game, I'm Chris Hagan in Baton Rouge. Back to you.
Enjoy my day at Hendrick Toyota Scion Concord. I was thinking I might get a Prius today, but I got to tell you about some basketball first. Alabama State's hosting Fort Valley. Now, last year, Fort Valley had an outstanding season. They were 21-9, went to the SIAC championship game where they lost to Tuskegee, who had a great season themselves. And Alabama State's always been one of the tough teams in the SWAC. So this should be a very interesting non-conference game. It's the last non-conference game for both of them getting the conference play. And we're going to sit back. I'm waiting for the keys to a Prius. And all you got to do is watch the ball game. Alabama State and Fort Valley State.
As Stan mentioned, it was Jackson against Jackson as Alabama State took on Fort Valley State and their coach, Sammy Jackson. Early on, it was all Alabama State. Jamel Waters with the flush as the Hornets take an early lead as coach Sammy Jackson looks on. And he got a chance to watch Bobby Brown do a lot of things like this. He throws it down with the dunk. 41-30, Hornets led at the break. In the second half, the question was, what can Brown do for you? Well, Bobby Brown can take every little step and make three-pointers from downtown. He had 16 points on the evening. Then his teammate, Luther Page, wanted to get in on all the action. On the fast break, he finishes with the dunk as Alabama State extends their lead to 20 at that point. More Luther Page. He says, give it to me down low. I'm going to back down the defender. Back down the defender, then go up for the easy score. Wendell Lewis will miss, but Brandon Graham is there for the putback slam. The Alabama State Hornets finish out the year of 2014 with a big victory over Fort Valley State by a final score of 76-65. Now there's another Jackson that coaches inside of Montgomery at Alabama State, and that's Coach Lewis's wife, and that's Freda Freeman Jackson. Her Lady Hornets were taking on Grambling State in their SWAC opener. Early on, it was the Lady Tigers knocking things down left and right thanks to Clintisha Martin. She steps back for three, and it's good as Grambling cut into Alabama State's lead. But after Coach Freda Freeman Jackson gave her team a great pep talk, it was all Alabama State. They got a lot of Britneys on their team. This time they go to Brittany Wright as she gets the layup. Later on, it's her teammate Danielle Ewert getting the rebound and finishing with the putback as Alabama State just continued to roll on. One more time for Jasmine Peoples. She would get a bucket here. She led all scorers for Alabama State as the Lady Hornets go on to claim a SWAC victory over Grambling State by a final score of 53-30. In Montgomery, Alabama, I'm Mo Carter for Inside the Game.
When we return, it's the SWAC versus the MEAC as NCCU, them Eagles, swoop into Mississippi to meet Valley and Jackson State. And Inside the Game catches up with former Alabama State and now Cleveland Brown star Isaiah Crowell.